problems you mentioned. I just have, so maybe a provocative question. Like a lot of the, so like the social solution you suggest, they look to me very similar to basically like a rule of the mob, the mobology sort of system. So for example, you say, stocks of companies should be owned by the people and the people should decide what companies do.
Like no, the money is owned by the central. The money generation would be the right of the people, right? It would be created by a new kind of central bank on behalf of us, but everyone would lend that money, and that means stocks are being bought by the money. And the overall idea is our economy would have to serve our society, technology would be used also to serve our society. And today it's the other way around,
what right? And another example was, for example, scientists should autonomously decide to whom to give the money instead of having some expert deciding. Like you could decide which medical research to fund. This looks like a follow-up, like a demagogy to me.
It might be a good idea to discuss this over coffee.
This is an interesting debate, but in many cases, you know, stock traders would say, oh, I'm the expert of what's going on in the stock market, and 90% of people, if not more, in the world are just so dumb and uninformed, they cannot take these kind of investment decisions. And then there are those famous experiments where you take an ape and let him throw darts or type into a keyboard and make investments randomly, more or less. And it turns out that they often outperform very good stock traders. And also indices typically outperform the portfolio of an expert stock trader, right? And this is exactly because the crowd is smarter than even an expert. Now, what I was proposing is not that the rule of the mob. I was saying, let's use information systems to turn beginners into experts by offering them the organizational tools that would be needed to turn you into an entrepreneur. And let's use augmented reality to give people instructions what to do and